Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to the Midwood High School spring production, A Night on Broadway. We're going to take you on a journey of scenes, songs, and dances from Broadway and movies. Sit back, relax, and enjoy the show. Our first piece is from Rent. Throughout the musical, the characters are constantly in the battle between two opposing forces. Their need to find a connection and free expression as artists, and their need to make ends meet. The classic 80s John Hughes film, The Breakfast. Harvest Club that features a film with five main stars talking about everything. This scene was unscripted, none of it was written down. The director and writer John Hughes told the actors to ad-lib. The actors made up the stories of why they were in detention.
Like When I step outside myself, kinda, and when I look in at myself, and I don't like what I see, I really don't.
What's wrong with you?
Because I'm like, stupid. Because I'm failing shop. See, we had this assignment to make this ceramic elephant. I got an F on it. Never got an F in my life. When I signed up, you know, for the course, I thought, wow, it'll be such an easy way to maintain my grade point average.
Why do you think it'd be easy?
Have you seen some of the adults that take shop?
I take shop. You must be a goddamn idiot.
I'm an idiot because I can't make a lamp?
No, you're a genius because you can't make a lamp.
What do you know about trigonometry?
I couldn't care less about trigonometry.
Bender, did you know without trigonometry there'd be no engineering?
Without lamps, there'd be no light.
Okay, so neither one of you is any better than the other one.
I can write with my toes.
I can also eat, brush my teeth.
With your feet?
Play hard and solo on the piano.
I can make spaghetti.
What can you do?
I can, take all your buns.
I want to see what Claire can do.
I can't do anything.
Now come on, everyone can do something.
Okay, there's one thing I can do. No, forget it. It's way too embarrassing.
You ever seen Wild Kingdom? That guy's been doing that show for 30 years.
Okay, but you have to swear you won't laugh. I can't believe I'm actually doing this.
Alright, great. Would you learn how to do that?
Camp, 7th grade.
Wow, Claire, that was fantastic. My image of you was totally blown.
Don't do that to her. You swore to God you wouldn't laugh.
Am I laughing?
You're a jerk.
What do you care what I think anyway? I don't even count, right? I could disappear tomorrow, and it wouldn't make any difference. I might as well not even exist at the school, remember? And you don't like me anyway.
You know, I have just as many feelings as you do, and it hurts just as much when somebody steps all over them.
God, you are so pathetic! Don't you ever, ever compare yourself to me, okay? You've got everything and I have nothing. Freaking Rapunzel, right? School probably shut down if you didn't show up. Queenie isn't here.
Shut up.
I like those earrings, Claire.
Shut up.
Did you work for the money to get those earrings, Claire?
Shut your mouth.
You know what? I bet those are a Christmas gift, right?
Shut up!
You know, yeah, they are a Christmas gift. You know what I got for Christmas this year? It was a banner year at the Bender family. Dad got me a carton of cigarettes. Grammy said he smoked up, Johnny. So if you're gonna cry, go somewhere else. Don't cry here, okay?
Oh God, are we gonna be like our parents?
Not me, ever.
It's unavoidable. It just happens.
What happens?
When you grow up, your heart dies.
Who cares? An aspiring singer immediately finds herself in trouble. Coming to her rescue is a bar act from the legendary Bourbon Room. With stars in their eyes, the young lovers chase their dreams, but a misunderstanding threatens to tear them apart.
And all my mind and
that would be enough, we see contrast between Hamilton, who will never be satisfied despite his spectacular political accomplishments, and his wife Eliza, who is content with the love of her family.
I was too young and blind to see.
Miss Pontius Pilate, did you ever think that you could feel sorry for Pontius Pilate?
I ask him to say what had happened, how this all began. I ask again, never said a word, as if he hadn't heard. And next, the room was filled with a wild and angry man. They seemed to hate this man. They cursed at him and then he disappeared. And then I saw thousands of millions crying for this man. And I heard them mentioning my name and leaving me the blame.
The soulful song is sung by Fantine, who is a very naive, destitute, working class girl who is seduced by a wealthy student.
I dream that love would never die.
Hammerstein, how do you know when to put a song into a musical? Hammerstein said, when the emotion of the moment is too big to just talk about. Here is Oscar Hammerstein's expression of the moment when a man is told that he will become a father.
No money, no change.
job. You can't have fun with a son, but you gotta be a father to a girl. Oh, you'd be so mad at that. A kid with his hair. A kind of neat and petite little tit-tot of her mother. What a care.
Ooh.
Suddenly I see him standing there, a beautiful stranger.
Nightclub sensation Velma murders her philandering husband, and Chicago's slickest lawyer, Billy Flynn, is set to defend her. But when Roxy also winds up in prison, Billy takes on her case as well, turning her into a media circus of headlines. Neither woman will be outdone in their fight against each other and the public for fame and celebrity. Miss Williams and the Midwood High School Band.
You must be a man. Then he runs more in. He runs.
sister-in-law eloped with John Barker Church, a British entrepreneur, in 1777, the couple settled in Boston. When the revolution was over, they moved abroad, and Angelica was eventually introduced to Jefferson in Paris in 1787. The two became friends and exchanged letters in which Jefferson expressed his affection and respect for her.
There's nothing rich folks love more than going downtown and snubbing it with the poor. They pull up in their carriages and gawk at the students in the comments just to watch them talk. Take Philip Schuyler, the man is loaded. Uh-oh, well, little does he know that his daughters, Peggy, Angelica, Eliza, sneak into the city just to watch other guys that
work.
Angelica,
work,
work.
Eliza,
work, work.
The Schuyler sisters.
They gave me good work rates, they negotiable retirement, vacation days, and even health care. The best thing about unions is that they help workers and the middle class.
I am a school aide here at Midwood High School. 10 years ago, I would have never seen myself here. I went to school for accounting, and I worked at a firm for a couple of years, but then I realized that it just wasn't for me. So I went back to school and studied psychology, specifically counseling, and now I'm here.
Hi, I'm in the UFT, which is the United Federation of Teachers. Being in this union has been good to me, because I'm protected against things that are not in my contract. Like, somebody can't come up to me and say, hey you, on Saturday at 7 p.m., you have to be here. Not gonna get paid, but you have to be here. Are there any setbacks? I don't know. Except how people in the public view us.
Hi, I'm a security guard at Midwood High School. I love my job. I love how people need identification to work in the building. And I also like my job because I feel like my kids are safe at school.
Why are you in the halls?
Have lunch.
What is your pass? That's not a pass.
It's my ID.
Let me see. All right, get out of my hall. Okay.
This is Harry Wexler was driving in New York City when the phrase natural woman occurred to him. He happened to drive by Carol King, and he rolled down his window and asked her to use the phrase to craft a song for Aretha Franklin. King and her then-husband, Jerry Goffin, wrote, "You Make Me Feel Like a Natural Woman," giving Wexler a writing credit for his suggestion.
Came along to play with it.
comes just after Alexander Hamilton admits his extramarital affair in a public pamphlet, hoping to salvage his legacy by coming clean about everything. But the revelation and the publicity shatters his wife, Eliza, who at that point in the show launches into Burn, an emotional ballad about heartbreak.
Oh, can see the world with open eyes. You can let it back, just don't hold me back. Now the time to take a chance. With the strength of a thousand men, climbing to my feet again. Try to see us on your walls, and everything will be alright. Another rainbow starts inside. Let your wings up high to rise. If your heart feels overwhelmed, no, you're never by yourself. Put your hand in mine, put your head up high, and together we'll rise. Never lift your head up to the sky. Find yourself as you know. Everything about it, but the hardships of your life. The biggest in my heart.
Just a man, and I'm Five hundred 25,600. and all.